From San Francisco, here is the morning news with Bob Dunn.
When I was a boy, my mother often said to me, get married, boy, and see how happy you will be. I have looked all over, but no girlie can I find who seems to be just like the little girl I have in mind. I will have to look around until the right one I have found. I want a girl just like the girl that married dear old Dad. She was a pearl and the only girl that Daddy ever had. A good old-fashioned girl with a heart so true, one who loves nobody else but you. I want a girl just like the girl that married dear old Dad.
I want a girl just like the girl that married dear old Dad. She was a pearl and the only girl that Daddy ever had.
A good old-fashioned girl with a heart so true, one who loved nobody else but you. I want a girl just like the girl that married dear old Dad.
The town of Vinh Linh, just inside the border of North Vietnam, was struck today by U.S. and South Vietnamese planes. One South Vietnamese plane was lost, however the pilot parachuted safely, and the Soviet news agency TASS claims that three U.S. planes were lost. Today's target area was 75 miles south of Dong Hoi, where American planes struck yesterday in retaliation for the communist attack on the American base at Pleiku on Saturday. During a Washington news conference, Defense Secretary Robert McNamara described yesterday's raid.
U.S. aircraft took off from three U.S. carriers that were steaming in the South China Sea. These carriers were steaming south of the 17th parallel, which is the line of demarcation between North and South Vietnam, about 100 miles off the coast of South Vietnam. The three carriers were the U.S. Ranger, U.S. Hancock, and Coral Sea. Of the aircraft which took off from the carriers, 49 struck the Dong Hoi barracks and staging area in the southern part of North Vietnam.
Eight Americans were killed in the communist guerrilla attack which touched off the current crisis, and the cleanup of that base is now underway. ABC's Bob Young has a report.
Cleanup after disaster began today at the Air Force base at Phi Ku, Camp Holloway. An inspection team checked the debris to recover usable parts from the remains of the burned and twisted helicopters. In addition to the eight Americans who lost their lives, more than 100 were wounded, and many have been evacuated from South Vietnam to military hospitals elsewhere. The Phi Ku attack was the worst inflicted.
Yeah.
Six of our helicopters were destroyed, 10 more badly damaged. One Caribou transport plane was also nearly destroyed, 3 other observation aircraft slightly damaged. An alert sentry in the barracks area is credited with keeping the casualty toll low in the midst of the fierce mortar attack. He heard the Viet Cong laying explosive charges against doors and windows. He gave the alarm, and he opened fire. Then he was killed himself by the guerrillas.
Advisor McGeorge Bundy returned to Washington late last night from Saigon and went immediately to report to President Johnson. This morning, Bundy reported on his findings to a meeting of the National Security Council attended by the President and leaders of both parties. After this morning's meeting, President Johnson said the U.S. will answer any threat, pay any price to make sure that freedom does not perish. And he warned against any miscalculation of America's strength.
I'm looking through you.
Russia warned this morning that the U.S. attacks on North Vietnam could have the most serious consequences, and Izvestia called the raids a gross act of aggression. Meanwhile, anti-American, or rather American anti-aircraft missiles are now on their way to Vietnam. Mary Tom, a 17-year-old high school girl from Jamaica, New York, was named Miss Chinatown USA in San Francisco's Chinatown late yesterday. Miss Tom, who is flanked here by the second and third place winners, will be crowned this week during the Chinese New Year celebration. And I'll be back with a Bay Region weather forecast after this one.
From San Francisco, here is the morning news with Bob Dunn.